Today, we are going to learn about sounds and vibration.
Hello, Ben.
And we are going to make a tin can telephone. It's very easy. We're going to connect two cups with a string. You're going to need two paper or plastic cups, a string or a yarn, something to poke a hole, and a tape. First, poke a hole in the cup. Safety. If you can't poke a hole in the cup, ask your parents to. Next, we're gonna put the yarn through the hole. Cut the yarn as long as you want the telephone to be. Put the yarn inside the hole. Tie a knot at the end. Then use the tape to put the string on the bottom of the cup. And repeat with the other cup. Let's take a look at how to tie this knot. First, make a small loop. Put the middle end through the loop. Then tighten the loop. This is called a slip knot. Like the first one, use tape to secure the string. You need two people to play the telephone. One will talk, one will listen.
Can you hear me?
It works, that's awesome. Let's understand how sound works. When something vibrates, it makes sound. It's like when you play a guitar and the string vibrates. But unlike guitar, our phone string did not shake up and down like this. When you talk to the cup, your voice shakes the bottom of the cup. It makes the string vibrate sideways to the other side. Then the bottom of the other cup vibrates. And that's how sound is recreated. Can you hear me?
I cannot hear you.
Now, Teddy didn't hear me. This is because the vibration stopped when the string wraps around the corner. How do we keep the string vibrating? There you go, this works. Just attach it to another string at the corner. If you don't have a paper cup, just find other objects like ship's container to make your telephone. There you go, have fun. Thanks for watching.
I cannot hear you.
Don't forget to subscribe.